Aqualung on 108.9 The Hawk, the 108.9 The Hawk morning show. I am Wisp Turlington, of course, here with my very good friend, Jeff, the itty bitty baby.
No. He's not here anymore.
It happened last show.
It is canon. Until he comes back, I am Jeff the Anger Man Garlic, at least to you.
And people, so you're going to not be the itty bitty baby.
I would prefer to not be. I just have a feeling, but look, if it happens, it happens. But
did you feel in that moment that you were truly an itty bitty baby?
I mean, I felt like I was back in the womb.
You did.
So it was both comforting and depressing all at once.
Almost as
depressing as the fact that we live in a world now where we can't use the word panties in songs anymore. I mean, Tull really nailed it on that one, I gotta say.
Really completely advancing the use of the word panties in classic rock or progressive rock. Not anymore, man. Not anymore.
Now that's the world we live in, apparently.
That's the world we live in. You say panties in a song now. All of the woke crowds will come after you, if you know what I mean.
I know exactly what you mean.
And I consider myself...
I feel like we got Willie Crystal coming in here.
I know. I consider myself to be the most woke of everybody.
Oh, yeah. You definitely are. And when I say all of my friends, I say Wisp Turlington is the wokest. And I don't even have to finish the sentence. People fill it in.
I've been in radio since 73.
Oh.
And I know that right there makes me woke.
That's when you know. If someone is very old and still doing the same job, they are gonna be the wokest you've ever met.
Everybody wants to hear a really old radio DJ say woke a lot of times on a classic rock morning show, correct?
Yes, I'm marking that one out as correct. You just got an A+ on that test.
Good. I got the little apple sticker that sometimes smelled like an apple, but other times just smelled like a sticker.
I'd scratch it anyways.
And it is 108.9 The Hawk Morning Show. Let's see, 7:33. We've got some great guys that are going to talk to us here in a second. They're doing some comedy at Dingbats. We're going to get the lowdown on that. But first, it's weather.
It's time for weather on 108.9 The Hawk.
Cold.
This freaking cold. What else can we say about it? Right outside of Dingbats, though, actually. Extra cold.
Extra cold at Dingbats tonight, where they're going to be doing a show.
With Dingbats is they never turn that AC down.
Never do. It's always pumping. It's the coldest place on earth. Great for comedy. Great for skit comedy.
Oh, there's nothing better to watch a good skit comedy if it is freezing cold. You want to make sure that those performers got nothing to sweat about.
You want to make sure those performers have nothing to sweat about. I do have to say this, Jeff. This is a new thing. Hawk Weather brought to you by Sharnies. Nobody eats for free at Sharnies. Go on out to Sharnies, try their new Salisbury Steak Buffet, get the All-American Burger, see Ma Sharney herself, and it'll be great. You're going to really love it.
You know, I got to say, before you go, that sweet and sour chicken fountain that Ma started to put out right by the hostess desk.
Put it in my mouth.
Before you, while you're waiting, you put it in your mouth.
It's the
while
best thing.
While you are waiting.
Nothing like a good buffet, and they've got it covered. I like it when I go to Sharnies and I get a good plate of everything. I got the bourbon chicken. I go to the steak station. I load up on steak. I got so much meat. And I like it when everybody walks by, like they come in and they pay their $20 and they look by, they walk by and they look at my plate to get a feel for what we're going to eat. And I love that. I love to be eating and constantly have people just staring down what I'm eating.
You know what I love? I like to order a good plate of everything. That's when they will pick everything for you. And you don't know how they're treating that food.
You don't know how they're treating it.
You don't know how they're treating it.
I don't think they're treating it good. I imagine
they're not treating it well at Sharnies.
Not at Sharnies.
But when it goes into my gullet and people are staring at me and they know exactly what I'm eating, that's a good feel. And then I know I'm home.
I know I'm home. And speaking of home, home is Val Verde. And speaking of comedy, we got two guys in the studio with us this morning who are bringing the laughs, Jeff, to Dingbats
bring
tonight.
Bring in the laughs, bring in the larfs. That's great.
Let's see here. I have it on paper. Scotty, is this right? Did you give me the right information today?
Yeah, Scott, we got to have this thing on paper because I have no idea who these guys
all
are.
Right,
we could just tell you.
We can tell you our names.
No, don't you worry.
This is our job. We'll get it. Don't worry about it.
All right. It is. Nope, not that one.
Scotty.
My name is Nick.
It does say that right here.
We got
Nick.
That's on the paper.
That is on the paper.
All right. We got that one. Nick, hello.
Also, the petting zoo at the Val Verde County Fair, apparently, Jeff, is open.
Oh, that is great to know.
Huge news.
They have got the biggest llama you've ever seen.
Are you guys interviewing us, or what's happening?
We're right in the middle.
We've been here for 45 minutes.
This
is so early for us.
Well, it's early for us, too.
Every morning feels like hell.
Every morning is hell. You must be Brian. You must be Nick from Britain.
BriTANick. You're from England. Fantastic. Some of my favorite bands are from England. I love
British bands, like the Kinks. You guys know the Kinks.
The Kinks are fantastic. I love a good skiffle band. You know, like I like the roots of British boys playing music.
Lonnie Donegan.
We're not British.
We're not from English.
You're not from English.
Doesn't seem like you understand English either. What is going on? We're having fun here. These are LARFs and barfs.
It's so early, guys. Can we just ease into this a little bit?
Okay. Let's pretend.
We had a pretty big night in Val Verde last night.
Should we back this up a little?
Let's back this up. Let's beep it up.
Beep it up.
We're backing it up.
Just to be clear, we're backing up to introducing us, right? Not to like some other report.
Yeah. Can you check the page? Who are these people?
I got the paper. Hold on.
We can just tell you.
No. Don't worry about that. You had a rough night in Val Verde last night. So don't worry about that.
Val Verde is rough when you're here on tour.
God forbid. Did you guys go to Flappers last night? Did you go to Flappers? Did you get the wings?
We started at Flappers.
That's how you got to start the night.
The Tower of Long Island Iced Tea.
Oh,
yeah.
It's just a tower.
They
only serve one thing. So, yes, that's what we got.
That's all we could get there.
You couldn't even get a small drink. They were like, oh, a tower, one tower.
No, and then it was like truly the one story high, like an actual tower.
It really is.
I think
it is a large tower.
Yeah, those guys that get on the phone towers on TikTok, you know, they have to do those towers for this. But that's besides the point. Scotty, I got the information right here. It is Nick and Brian from BriTANick.
Yes.
There you go. That's
oh, we're saying it right. So not from England. All right.
Not from England or from English.
Where are you guys from?
We're actually from Atlanta.
Ooh,
Atlanta, Georgia.
Yeah. Hot Atlanta. That's what they say. Big radio town.
Yes.
I mean, they did say that
for a while. I don't know.
Yeah.
Oh, they still do.
It's been about 10 years, I think, since I've heard that. But yeah.
Yeah.
When Ludacris gets out of his car, he's like, it's good to be in Hot Atlanta every day.
Every single day.
He's getting
even
out
when
of
he's
World
not
of
in
Coke.
Hot Atlanta.
Even when. Yeah.
He's in Roanoke, Virginia.
He's like, good to be in Hot Atlanta. It really confuses the Roanoke people. It does.
Yeah.
Okay, but hey, guys, you guys are here. You had a tough night at Flappers. Apparently, from what Scotty says here, you're doing skit comedy tonight at Dingbats.
Yes, we're very excited. This is actually our first radio show.
Our manager made us take this. Words are
important. You know that because you're skit writers.
Right.
Words are very important in skits.
It's called sketch.
Scotty. You should have put that down there, Scotty.
Scotty, did you know that it is not called a skit?
He says it might be a skit. I don't care if you call it skit or sketch comedy.
I agree with Nick, but just the way they said skit so many times made me feel like
the
I had to
defend
it.
The tone you're putting on skit,
the tone.
I don't love. I don't care. Some people care about that. I think it's stupid to care about that.
So if I say, you guys are doing skit comedy.
That's better.
Yeah, okay.
That's better?
That's a good tone.
Yeah, I like that actually a little bit.
Okay, well, sketch comedy, very, very fantastic. Everybody loves sketch comedy. I can just run off some of my favorite shows. Mad TV.
Yeah.
Sure. Mm-hmm. Fantastic.
Yep. That was good. It's a fun show.
Hee-haw.
Hee-haw. Hee-haw. Hee-haw. That's the best of it right there.
That was
older
some good
one,
stuff.
Yeah.
It's been a while since
Yeah, that's pretty...
That's all the sketch I'm aware of.
Mad TV and Hee Haw are your guys' two touchstones for
sketch. We like to laugh.
You can't stop laughing.
Nick, we love to laugh.
Oh, you know who I also like? Red Green. I love that Red Green guy. He's that Canadian guy who just, he fixes everything with duct tape. He has a whole channel on the elderly station. So he is funny.
Sketch comedy? This guy.
You got to check out Red. It's funny.
It's funny.
It's funny.
It's on the elderly channel.
Yeah,
you got to go deep. You got to go deep into your cable for that one.
Yeah. What's mostly on that channel?
Red Green. Yeehaw.
Hee-haw. Oh,
Mad TV.
Sit and Stretch. It's that elderly workout that show.
Sense. Is this like a special package you have to order from the satellite provider?
Well,
like,
I think it comes with
you got it.
Ticket.
You got it. You got to check out. You got to keep on
we
going.
We all have the elderly channel.
We all have it. Yep.
Yeah.
Wow. Broadcast
it's about,
right
it's
here from Val Verde.
15,000, I think. You got to keep going.
Yeah.
You go past the Spanish language channels. You go past the radio. We're on there, by the way. Did you know that, Wisp? We're on 108.9 The Hawk is
on the
cable
channel.
There's nothing better than watching live radio on a TV show.
Nothing better. We're on every morning. You guys are actually on the elderly channel right now.
You're on
Look up there at that camera. Just wave. They're excited to see you because technically they watch, and you guys are young guys. You guys are young guys. So they kind of sucking your life force through the TV.
It's like a cocoon situation.
It is almost like a cocoon. If they were going to make Cocoon 3, it would be this little scenario right here talking about skit comedy.
I've not seen Cocoon.
And I don't love
it. It's exactly like this. It's basically this plot.
And the interesting part is
Wilford
Brimley
Cocoon?
Was the same age you are currently in Cocoon.
That is true.
Okay.
So basically,
well, not having seen Cocoon, I don't really know what that means. Is he young?
I think you know what Wilford Brimley looks like. Well, he's never changed to the way he's looked.
He was the diabetes guy. He's dead now, but he's the diabetes guy.
His ads are on the elderly channel quite often.
Yes.
Seems like a lot of stuff's on the elderly channel.
There's so much lawnmowers.
Lawnmowers. It's a fantastic channel.
It's just riding lawnmowers.
Red Green's on again.
Can I ask, do you guys watch the elderly channel because it would take too long to flip away from it to get back to a regular channel?
I mean, it is deep in there, and I forget what my previous channel would have been.
Because you're deep in the soundscapes channels, like all those.
Oh,
like,
God. Yes. Music Choice. God. I'm all over Music Choice. I'm listening.
Music
Easy listening.
Choices.
Classic.
That's my type of TV.
That's the real music television, you know.
It is.
Exactly.
They still play music.
Yeah.
Unlike MTV or MTV2.
I don't know if you've noticed
that
on MTV. VH1. They don't play music anymore.
I had a show on VH1 for a little bit. It was nice. The Wisp Turlington show, of course. But you were asking what the movie Cocoon was about. So
yes,
just a
good question.
Quick scenario, a quick breakdown here. It is a Ron Howard film.
Yes, it is.
It's about a bunch of old bastards who meet Steve Guttenberg, who meets an alien that Steve Guttenberg wants to fuck.
Yes,
and
that's
then
the main
Scotty,
drive
you're gonna
of
have
his
to throw
character.
The delay on that one.
Have you? I assume he put it on once we started talking Cocoon because he knew
that,
we were going to talk about the Cocoon.
We're
going to
get nasty when we talk about Cocoon. So Guttenberg, he just wants to fuck the hell out of this one alien. I don't think it makes him younger, but then that one alien that he wants
makes
to
him less
fuck,
horny though. I'll tell you that
does
much.
Make him less horny. The alien he wants to fuck then takes all the old people in town and takes them to another planet.
Yes,
where they live forever.
Yeah. And the most interesting part is the fucking is a lot like in Demolition Man. It is a lot like in the Coneheads film, not the sketch. It is a mind fuck, really. And that's the interesting, because the movie itself is a bit of a mind fuck, too. So.
I prefer the Coneheads movie over the Coneheads skit.
That's it. You guys are skit comedian. I'm sorry, sketch. Skit.
You guys
what is your guys' opinion on the Coneheads film?
What do you think about the Coneheads film?
I saw it so long ago.
We don't really talk about it that often.
Okay.
I would say it couldn't be less of an influence on us, I suppose.
I don't think our humor is anything like Conehead humor. I think people have noted that to us.
I got to be honest. I don't even really remember what Conehead humor is. I know they have cones for heads.
They're
aliens.
They're smart, right?
They fake that they're
debatable.
From France. Yeah, they're
it
not really even that
smart.
They act like they're from France.
Yeah.
Right.
Yep, they enjoy eggs and beer.
Ooh, yeah.
He is a driving instructor.
And it says here, Scotty put here too, you guys once wrote for Saturday Night Live.
Oh,
we did.
And that's
yeah.
the skit show that Coneheads came from. How
that
many Coneheads did you write while at Saturday Night Live?
Yeah. We actually, that was decades before our time.
They haven't done a Coneheads in a long time.
Wow. Yeah. I think if we'd even tried to pitch one, we would have been fired.
It would have been a big faux pas.
Oh, so you didn't even try pitching one. Interesting.
You didn't even pitch one.
That's probably
why you were fired.
Yeah.
I think that would have been a great Hail Mary move in our final week. I think so, too. That would have been nice. Pitching a Coneheads. Yeah.
Maybe at Wayne's World. Maybe you're like, hey, Lauren, we've got this on the table.
Why not? You know?
Could we do a Wayne's World? And Lauren's like, I don't want them to do a Wayne's World while he's scarfing down some popcorn.
Excuse me.
Lauren Michaels' impression is as good as your Ludacris.
You know, I've worked on both.
Now tell me this. You love Mad TV, and you mentioned it as one of your influences.
Yes.
And then you didn't even, you said that's pretty much all the sketch you knew, that and Hee Haw, but it seems like you know about SNL.
I remember. It's also on my little paper here, too.
I know because it's a variety show.
Yeah, that's
it's
a variety show. That's not a sketch show.
And we're there for the music. And
if you knew that, maybe you wouldn't have been fired.
Yeah, maybe you didn't understand what you were writing on there.
It could have been any number of reasons.
It could have been.
No, probably because you didn't understand it was a variety show, not a sketch show. Because, you know, they have
musical
acts.
Is what you're saying?
Who would you pitch?
I'd probably go into Lauren's office, and I would I'd sit down, and I'd say, first off, I'm going to reach out, and I'm going to grab some candy from his bowl.
Of course.
Uh-huh. It's popcorn, normally.
It is. There's no candy?
No candy.
I remember popcorn, Nick.
But he's just sitting there playing like Snood or something on his computer, right? He's not even fucking paying attention.
Well,
we never
would get that close enough to see what was on the computer screen.
I saw Snood.
You did see?
I saw Snood.
Wow. Uh-oh, Nick. Wow. He saw Snood.
I mean, maybe that's another reason we got fired is I didn't get close enough to see Snood.
Or maybe I peeked and saw a snood and he got mad.
You're a snood peeker. I see. Snood That's probably peeker. Why. He probably looked up, saw you from the vent, and he's like, snood peeker.
That's, I was in the vent,
whoa,
yes.
Lord.
Man, he is just like the ox. You know, John Entwistle was known as a snood peeker from the
He was a snood peeker, too.
He was that little fact.
We're going to talk more about this great, great skit comedy show coming up at Dingbats tonight. I want to hear all about it from the BriTANick guys. We do have to go to traffic real fast.
108.9 The Hawk Traffic with Art Spart.
Well, if I didn't see it with my own eyes, I wouldn't believe it. But right now, I have to report nothing. There is nothing going on. Not one accident. There's no jackknife truck, overturned farmer delivery pickup, massive water main explosion that is turning the roads into a lake, or let's say a drone attack. The roads are smooth sailing out here from Kirk Hammett Way to Hog Street. It's a pleasure to drive in Val Verde. For once, I have to say, it's a pleasure. I don't like it at all. It feels uncomfortable. I feel uncomfortable both in my own skin and, frankly, my place in this world. Hell, this universe. Without traffic, what is Art Spart? All these years at parties, conferences, hell, the gas station, I was known as Art Spart Traffic at 108.9 Mohawk. And now, without accidents, without traffic, without anything to report, I have to be just comfortable with being Art Spart. Solo. Just a human being. And frankly, that is an uncomfortable place to be. I'm going to level with you, Val Verde. Art is going to have to do some soul searching. Art's going to have to look inward. Art is going to have to, as they say in the therapy biz, do the work. Because for the first time in his life, and of course, I am still talking about myself, Art Spart, I'm going to find out who Art Spart is. And frankly, I am scared. And hoping that I don't end up finding the answers after some long nights with my old friend, the bottle. Pray for me, Val Verde. Wait, hold the phones. We actually just had a hit and run right in the middle of Phil Linnett Avenue. Now cars are slamming into each other, trying to avoid the carnage. Forget everything I said because it is a humdinger of an accident down there that is going to send ripples through all of Val Verde. And I'm back, baby. This is Art Spart with 108.9 The Hawk.
It's time for weather on 108.9 The Hawk.
Really, we're doing weather again?
We know that
we just did fucking weather.
I mean, we'll look at the various streets here. Okay. Phil Linnett Way, cold.
Go down there. Phil Linnett
Way, cold.
Cold. James Hetfield Way, which actually goes right up to Dingbats, colder.
Colder, yeah. Robert Trujillo Way, very cold.
They did, you know, the saddest thing. That used to be Jason Newsted Way. They took the sign down and they put Robert Trujillo Way up. And now Jason Newsted from Metallica does not have a road. Pretty shocking.
Very shocking.
We'll come back with these skit boys here in a second. But first, Oh, it's Deep Purple on 108.9. The Hawk.
Do you want the tastiest chicken wings in all of Val Verde? Well, then look no further than Flappers. Hello, I am the owner and proprietor of Flappers, Hunk Dankelman. And that is right, we continue to be back. We have not been taken out this time. I know that there have been multiple times we have not been able to serve you delicious chicken wings because of various drone attacks. Drone attacks and explosions and natural disasters. So now I have mortgaged my house just one more time against the wishes of my financial advisor for a new Flappers experience. So welcome to Flappers Bar and Chicken Wing Palace. We have the largest selection of drinks in all of Val Verde, including our Tower of Tea. That is, of course, a gigantic Long Island iced tea as tall as a skyscraper. I tell you, you will not be able to find a larger Tower of Tea anywhere in the greater Val Verde area. I'll also tell you, don't try to destroy us. Not gonna happen this time, all right? We are sticking where we are down here on Steely Way. Not gonna give you an exact address because I would like to survive this time. So come on down to Flappers. We ain't going nowhere.
Mugs, 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 mugs. That's what you'll get down at Jugs Mug Emporium. That's Jugs with four G's. Just so you know, they're serious. Hi, I'm Wisp Turlington for Jugs Mug Emporium. For over 90 years, the Jugs family have circled the globe to find you the absolute best in mugs. From I Heart Grandma to World's Loneliest Dad, you'll get that mug's itch scratched at Jugs Mug Emporium. Here's some of their latest mugs on sale now. Forget about what? I have amnesia. DUI stands for Dad's Unusually Interesting Tonight, isn't he? If shitting yourself is a crime, you give me the chair. And it's a nice little pic of a smiling baby. Classic Rock Never Divorced Me. And that one is an overstock 108.9 The Hawk mug. I Lost My Virginity to a lesser lineup of Deep Purple. And then two coffee mugs. You call it coffee, I call it liquid LSD. And then the same one, it says, you call it coffee, I call it Mommy's Sadness Juice. You want mugs? Then go get them. That one is also weirdly a mug. I don't know where they want you to go, but I imagine it's Jugs Mug Emporium. Oh yeah, you're gonna like these mugs. Also a mug for sale at Jugs Mug Emporium.
Jugs Mug Emporium, 323 Valley Crest Way.
What happens when a dental hygienist finds a secret map to a priceless bottle of wine in the molar of her favorite client, and they both go on a cross-country journey to combat their respective midlife crises, and on that journey, they also end up finding love? Hilarity is what happens. Billy Crystal, Deborah Winger, and David Johansen in I'll Show Myself Out, written by Lowell Ganz and Babalu Mandel, this Thursday on Channel 8, your home for great shit.
Hey, dads, go ahead and relax and crank up your favorite Steely Dan song on 108.9 The Hawk. Wait, what's that? The front door's opening. Oh, God, now your wife is gonna know you played hooky from work only so you could listen to your favorite Steely Dan song on 108.9 The Hawk. Oh, one of my favorite supergroups of all time, Traveling Wilburys. On 108.9 The Hawk. It is the 108.9 The Hawk morning show. Jeff, if you were gonna be a Wilbury,
you know,
like they all have their names.
Yes.
What would your Wilbury name be?
So you're asking me,
yeah,
if I was one of the members of the Traveling Wilburys?
No. I'm just saying, if they were still around, let's say Tom Petty's still alive.
Of course.
Let's say Bob Dylan is still alive.
Say Jeff Lynne is still alive.
Jeff Lynne is still alive. George Harrison is still alive.
Yes.
And they're like, Jeff, we would really like you to join the Traveling Wilburys. What would your Wilbury name be?
I think Don Amici.
No, goddammit, you have to have a Wilbury name.
I don't want to have a Wilbury name.
Well, then you're not in the Wilburys.
I don't want to be in the Wilburys.
You're not going to be in the Wilburys, then.
I'm not going to be in the Wilburys.
Scotty,
this is true.
Mark it down. He will not be in the Traveling
How
Wilburys.
How am I going to compete with every one of the members of the Traveling Wilburys?
You fucking blew it. And speaking of blowing it here, we got BriTANick with us. These guys had it all. They had it eaten out of the palm of their hand. At Saturday Night Live, and now they're looks like they're doing the show. So you're doing the show at Dingbats tonight. That's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah, and then you're going to be doing bad. We're like
doing fine.
We're working. Things are good.
Okay. Well, Nick,
I see they had some videos on YouTube. Oh, not everyone can get a video on YouTube. You can't, so that's how did impressive. You do that? How did you pull that
off?
That's
actually not what I'm referring to, but it's a very basic upload process. And you can just, you know, it's super, super simple.
So you talk to a guy.
Yeah.
And then the guy's like, okay, no. Nick, I'll talk to the people in charge.
There's no guy. No, you go right to it. There's no person in charge.
Holy shit.
Oh, so I shouldn't be that impressed. Maybe you're not doing as well as I thought there, because I was going off of the YouTube that you had videos on there.
Well, that's how we started. So that was before everything.
Yeah.
But yeah, you know, everyone can put stuff on YouTube.
If you go to www.youtube.com, there'll be a button that says upload, and that's basically...
Let me go to that
beginning.
This is a game changer. If we can get the Anger Man Garlock videos up there, I'll rant about everything on YouTube. People like writing videos on YouTube.
I'm on YouTube right now.
I don't know how many viewers the Elderly channel has, but I think if you guys put stuff on YouTube to supplement that, you could get a lot more views.
Really?
Interesting.
I think so.
Do you guys not have any videos or any content on the internet?
We don't have anything. We barely stream. Like, literally, we're pretty much just on the Elderly channel and on 108.9, the frequency here in the greater Valley area.
Yes.
The younger generation, like, that's... They're
I know the younger generation.
Wisp
I don't know
is a
if you
big
heard
TikTok
me.
Fan. He's
I'm
an
a
old,
big TikTok guy.
He is the oldest man here, and so
I know
he
the
definitely...
Dances.
He's woke, and he understands the youth.
Yep.
So you understand TikTok, but
TikTok's
not something
so easy.
You guys...
YouTube, not easy at all.
Not at all.
Because the videos are short on TikTok.
Right.
The videos are too long.
Yes.
On the YouTube.
I see.
And I will say, I watched a couple of your guys's, and man, they were pretty long.
Like 3 minutes, like 4 minutes.
Started zoning out pretty
quick. Everybody knows a good skit is, like, let's just reference Hee Haw like we did. The donkey pops up.
Yeah.
It says... or something like that. Who knows what the donkey says? He says, "Get out in the cornfield!" And I'm like, "Oh my God, donkey!" And that took 20 seconds.
Or something more modern, like laughing, right? Like, let's say laughing.
Speaking of Lorne.
It needs to be something like a Goldie Hawn comes on, she dances for like 10 seconds, then you're like, "That's funny. That's funny.
That's humor, guys." And I hope that's
humor. That's a lot like TikTok, actually, if I'm thinking about it now.
If we could just reference pop culture that was like, after 1989, that would be great. Because I'm familiar with laughing, but like
it seems
very
like we just have
passingly.
Different influences, you guys
okay.
and us.
All right.
Do you guys know anyone past 1989?
I watched one episode of In Living Color.
Yeah.
Okay, that's like right on the cusp of 1989.
Homie the Clown.
Very
did you
funny.
Guys
homie,
pitch,
don't play that.
Homie, don't play that. And did you guys pitch a Homie the Clown?
We didn't pitch anything that was done on any previous sketch show at SNL. We only tried to do original ideas.
Did you think about it?
Homie the Clown.
No, I don't think we talked about doing
it.
Well, that might have been your mistake.
That's probably what happened. And that's why you're
the
playing
head detective.
Dingbats.
I would have loved to seen a head detective on SNL. I think I would have really been. Maybe
it like
then
it
would have been Saturday
then?
Night Dead. And am I the first one to say that? Saturday Night Dead.
Did you just come up with that?
I just came up with that.
Oh my God.
I ain't angry for nothing. I'm peeved over there, but at SNL. But hey, I love it.
Well, it looks like Angry Band just popped out of his seat for a second. But guys, you know, you've done so much so far in your career. SNL, you know, big things on YouTube. You got videos on YouTube. And now you're playing Dingbats.
We're performing live for fun.
Our manager said you guys might as well stop through Val Verde. Is that it?
This is Val Verde. Yes, yes. Good manager, too, by the way.
Yeah, I don't know. We're sort of figuring out what we're going to do with him. We're on our way to Edinburgh. We're doing a show in Scotland, and you guys are just like, we're passing through you. So, yeah.
Hold on. That is on my list here. It says you are doing one show in Scotland.
No, we're doing 25
one
shows.
25? No. Why would you do? Are there people that are going to come out and see 25 shows?
It's unclear.
Yeah. We'll see, but ideally, there's a whole festival. It's a comedy festival. It's called the Edinburgh Fringe. We're performing there for a month.
Oh my God.
I can't imagine any of the people listening to this are gonna travel to Scotland.
I don't know. We got a lot. We have a very big Scottish community here in Val Verde, and they do like to go back and forth.
Really?
They really do.
Interesting.
They really do.
How did the Scots find their way here?
Well, in the 1700s, there was the Scottish plague. Uh-huh. You may not have heard of it. It may not have been in your history books, but there was the Scottish plague, and they got on boats and they hauled ass across. And they're like, "Hey, this looks like a little nice town."
But we are so inland.
Oh, like, we're inland.
So far from the sea.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
So they just traveled from the coast. They just walked all the way to Val Verde
Bay's down that way. It's at least an hour drive. But they walked.
Sorry, everybody.
That.
I'm back.
Where'd you go?
I ran out. I was writing down. I didn't have a notepad in front of me. I had to go take a shit.
I was writing up
a little head detective skit. For you all to maybe pitch to
No. We'll pitch you some stuff. So Jeff, when you were shitting, here's what you missed. They're doing a show at the
25 shows.
What? Oh, 25 shows. I mean, good luck at the Edinburgh Fringe Festival.
Interesting.
They're doing the show. Is it the same show you're doing at Dingbats tonight?
Yeah, we're gonna sort of try out Dingbats. We're messing with it a little bit. We're gonna change some stuff. But.
We'll do some regional Val Verde sort of humor to, you know.
Oh my God! Like
make
what?
Probably fun for this audience.
Can we get a taste?
A little taste sample.
One of the things was we talked about drinking a Long Island iced tea tower on stage to end the show.
That's good. Yeah, that's gonna end the show and you.
Yeah.
I don't know. Just people at Flappers last night were like, "You got to do it," and we're like, "Okay," but we had already gotten so drunk that I think we just agreed to something that we can't
sounds
really
like
pull
Flappers
off 2 nights in a row. Yeah.
We'll probably do some jokes about the air conditioning.
We're showing up on stage in like snow pants and huge coats, not as a joke, just because it's so fucking cold in there.
Cold.
Yes.
And I guess we're just gonna make a joke about that somehow. But yeah, the temperature and the alcohol. What else do we have?
Do you think that any of the jokes that you make here in our wonderful city of Val Verde will travel with you to Edinburgh? Because, like I said, big Scottish contingent here. If it works here, it may play very, very well with.
Absolutely not.
No,
we're not
going to
take
so
that risk. I don't think we can do any Val Verde jokes.
I think the Highlanders would enjoy a tower of iced tea joke.
I don't think it sounds like it's up a Highlanders alley.
We can't do a joke specific to the AC Dingbats in Val Verde in Scotland. There's no way that's going to translate.
Well, okay, you're fine.
I guess comedy's subjective.
It is subjective. Hey, do you have anything in your show? Because this is going to go great in Scotland. Do you have anything about the movie Highlander?
Oh, good question.
No.
Well, you know.
Yeah, really
also,
blowing it.
You know, if we were going to reference a movie, we would do a more recent one, I think. That's
Coneheads.
We referenced the Shawshank Redemption in
1986, so I'd love it if we could keep
Coneheads?
You know, past that 1989.
No, we're not talking about Coneheads anymore.
Oh, Highlander. Yeah, Highlander was
just keep in mind, The Quickening. That is what it's called. Just remember, if you just say The Quickening at some point, those Highlanders are going to lose it. Just keep that in your back pocket.
Yeah, we're not into, like, reference humor. We think it's kind of a cheap way to get a laugh.
That's very interesting. This is the process. I like hearing about what the comedy process is. Just one more suggestion. You guys walk out on that stage. How big's the stage in Edinburgh? I'm thinking it fits two chairs.
No. I mean, it's not huge. It's like a 90-person black box.
90-person black box. Okay. So the stage is going to be pretty big.
Yeah, not bad.
There's probably going to be about 15 people in the audience. So this will be perfect, guys.
90
is
the idea.
Well, it seats 90. You're not going to. I mean, let's be real here. But then you walk out on stage in Edinburgh, and you're just like, before you even, the lights go down, it's just fucking pitch dark in the box. And then everybody hears this.
Here we are, born to be kings.
Princes of the Universe theme from Highlander. And then, Nick, you pop out here.
Okay.
And you're pointing at all the audience members. You gotta remember to point.
The show's been written, like, we know what we're doing.
And then Nick's done here. He's done.
Right.
And then Brian's out. And Brian's just, like, hitting it. He's getting it.
And he's got his box of wigs. He's bringing up the wigs.
Just
he's throwing
wig after wig.
Can you be more specific about Brian getting it?
He's just out there with the...
Brian's just giving it and he's getting it.
Well, honestly, it's a dual Brian situation because Brian May's really wailing on guitar in the background. Yes. And then this Brian's out there just fucking just getting it. Like, he's doing hips.
I feel that.
Maybe you could put on a Brian May wig.
Oh,
that
would be
great.
Then we'll really have a dual Brian there.
Oh, my God. I think
we don't do any we've never worn wigs in our life on stage.
I've definitely seen Brian do hips before.
You've never seen Brian do... How long have you guys been doing comedy? Have you never seen this guy do hips?
You never seen me do... You've seen me do hips.
No, I said I did. I said I had seen you do hips. I've not seen you do
wigs. So you can check off that. Oh, well, because if, as far as I understand with sketch comedy, you got to have the hips. You got that.
You got to get
you gotta have wigs. You got to have a dildo. You got to fit a dildo in.
And not even if it's not even a joke. How many how many dildos in your bag?
Not a single dildo or wig. Godspeed
to get even 15 in that crowd at that point. I don't know what you're going to be doing there.
Are there awards at Edinburgh Fringe? Because there are awards at Dingbats.
Yeah, there's Best Newcomer, which would be great. Okay. And there's like Best of the Fest and some other ones. But yeah, yeah, there are some awards. What do Dingbats have?
Best Comer.
Yep, Best Comer.
I don't know exactly what that means.
Yeah,
or if they're referencing people coming, it is it's creepily C-U-M.
Okay, well that seems kind of clear what it means.
I don't even know why you had to ask. Well, who's won in the past and what'd they do?
Dane Cook.
Oh. Okay,
Dane Cook won four times in a row. Dave Attell
was who he took the crown from.
Yeah, it's an annual award.
Louis C.K. is he's on the big dog award. Louis got the big dog award for that one.
Yeah, I think I know what this is about. Yeah, yeah, I hope to not win Best Comer.
Sebastian Maniscalco.
Oh,
big newcomer. He's been the comer at least 18 times.
Big, yeah, at the very least.
And guys, you guys, at the end of the show, when you're just absolutely shithoused from your Long Island iced tea tower, you could be the newcomers.
We're going to be actively trying to not win this award, I think.
Well, the committee will already be there, so
they're working on it already. They're watching the Elderly Channel and they're taking notes. So
in every other comedy club in the world, this would be, you know, the winner of this would be arrested.
Welcome to Val Verde. They call us the New Austin. It's fantastic.
They have referred to us as the new. We do have an influx of a lot of comedians coming here.
Oh yeah, some comedians have moved from L.A. to Val Verde.
Yep, for freedom because we have a lot of freedom here.
Legion of Skanks Mach 2 is here. They're fantastic. They do fantastic work.
Skanks Mach 2.
Skanks
so
Mach 2
hilarious.
Is where it really takes off.
Oh, we've got the club, the Creek and the Caverns.
Yes.
It's very similar to the Creek and the Cave.
No,
in
it's
Long
not.
City.
It's not, and it's sounds, very different.
It's very similar.
The
very
same different. Owners or something?
It's actually in a caverns. They are down in Verde Caverns. You go down there. You do. If people laugh a lot, there are stalactites and stalagmites just dropping left and right.
There are mole people, and they are a tough crowd. You got to get the mole people.
If you laugh hard enough, then the stalactites fall?
Fall from the fucking
ceiling. That's so dangerous.
Well, it's very unstable.
Hack it, you get out. You go over to UCB Val. Yeah. We have an annex that's been opening over there.
Yeah.
If you guys can't hack it.
Oh yeah, UCB Val. We were very
UCB
excited
Val
about
is great.
That.
And do they pay performers?
Oh yeah.
Yes, in Bitcoin. Yeah. Bitcoin so and NFTs. Whatever an NFT is, you get paid in that. And it's actually it's co-owned by an NFT company. I think it's Bored Ape UCB Val. Am I correct in that?
No,
or
you're
crypto
right.
in there? I'm not
and
positive.
You can get paid in Bored Ape Bucks, but it's BUXXX.
Yes.
You guys know a lot about crypto, but you couldn't figure out uploading to YouTube.
I just have a crypto guy.
Yeah, okay.
Vinny.
Willie Vinny. Crystal and Vinny work together. Yeah,
they work together.
Yeah.
Willie Crystal's really good at it. I'm not good at it. But I am good at telling you one thing. You got to get down to Dingbats tonight. It looks like we do have some calls here. So let me go ahead and pop up line number three. You are on line number three.
Yeah, did I get them Val Verde County Fair tickets?
Oh. We're actually
here with BriTANick, sir. Would you like to talk to any of the BriTANick guys?
I would really like them In Val Verde County. Are they playing at the county fair?
They're not. You haven't booked anything at the county fair. That would be a good gig.
That would be a huge gig.
Just Dingbats. So, yes, sir, no. And we're not giving away tickets this session. So, sorry about that.
All right.
Well, that was easy. Good call there.
That went.
Okay. Line four.
Woo! Woo!
Yeah. Hey, 108.9 The Hawk.
Woo! You got tickets to Dingbats?
Oh, we've got tickets to Dingbats. Looks like we're giving away. What's the number, Scotty? Really? We've got 80 tickets to give away this morning.
What?
Yeah.
The capacity is 80. This is going to be fantastic. Are you telling me I got Sebastian Maniscalco tickets to Dingbats?
No. Maniscalco is next week. You've got the potential comers at Dingbats, BriTANick tickets, and you just won 80 of them.
Oh, I don't want to go see any potential
newcomers.
Don't
give them
newcomers.
All to one guy. Spread it out.
I don't know who is talking to me right now. I do not want all 80, all right?
Do you have 79 friends?
I do have 79 friends.
Well, then you got 80 tickets.
I have 79 friends who were saying Sebastian Maniscalco.
Well, they're not going to see Sebastian Maniscalco.
Well, then I'm going to see you later.
Oh, my God. So it said sold out on the Dingbats website.
Yeah.
But
Dingbats does that all
the tickets? They just gave you all the tickets.
There's a packet full of all the tickets.
Any show that happens at Dingbats, it goes directly to Tickets, which is, of course, our ticket broker company.
Yes.
They take all of the tickets immediately from every show, and then they give them to us.
Yeah, that's how it works,
guys. And they also usually sell them with a 500% markup.
Yeah, yeah. So we will, you guys, what's that, Nick? Sorry.
They didn't sell. I'm just wondering, if it's all been given away, has any money been generated? Like, this is,
I mean, that's something you're gonna have to talk to Dingbats
and your own god, because that's their bag.
I would consult your own god.
Not my god. Consult your own god.
My classic rock god. Hey, we're gonna talk more about this. Your show coming up. We gotta pay some bills. Oh, you're both atheists.
Oh, that's not going to do good for the show in Val Verde.
That's not going to help the comedy career at all, will it?
Comedy is all about God, as far as
we're
concerned.
Oh, my God. Hey, since we've been talking about it, and we want their show to go so well in Scotland, here's the Scottish National Anthem. It is Princess of the Universe, Queen.
What?
108.9 The Hawk. We'll be right back. Wait. Just as a reminder... Okay, this is the part. Hips.
Right, hips.
Okay,
yes.
We got
dildo. Get it.
Hey, man.
Okay, good. Thanks for the thought.
Can you hear me?
Oh, yeah. They listen to 108.9 The Hawk.
These classic rock stations think they know what's up when they play Jethro Tull, but they never play Steel Eye Span or Plain Steve or Incredible String Band or Albion Country Band or Clive's Original Band.
And you're listening to 108.9 The Hawk.
Family, community, service. These are the values we hold dear at Old Peterson's Plumbing and Sewage. You know what else we hold dear? Not talking about your gross bowel movements. Hello there. I'm Noel Peterson, owner of Old Peterson's Plumbing and Sewage. We've been serving the greater Val Verde community for over 40 years, fixing all sorts of plumbing problems from clogged toilets to septic systems. And you know how we've survived all those years? I don't ask you how the problem started, and you don't tell me how they started. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. The nitty-gritty of your butthole. I tell you, by God, every customer, they just want to explain to me what happened. Why their toilet is clogged and in graphic detail. Look, people, I just want to get in and get out without hearing about some massive dump you took and how you never knew that amount of poop could come out of a human body, and you wouldn't believe it if I described it to you. Well, trust me, I would. 40 years in the biz. I've seen it all. I don't need you to tell me about it. I don't know what it is about the town of Val Verde, but everybody wants to get into graphic detail about how loose or not loose their stool is. Oh, I'm sorry. Is this all too graphic for you? Talking about caca and poo-poo and feces? Well, imagine how I feel. I just want to do my job. And do it well, mind you. And every time I ask you what the problem is, well, last night we had this really big pasta dinner. Hold it right there, ma'am. I know where this is going, and I don't like it. I mean, what, does this get you people off or something? All I want to do is fix your toilet, not get sucked into your weird fantasies, if that's what's going on here. Quite frankly, I don't want to know. Even my wife knows not to bring up this stuff. We've been married 45 years, and she has not once asked me about my day at work. Because I asked her to not. I just want to enjoy my two houses, my lake house, and my wide collection of jet skis. Oh yeah, I do quite well. That's why I'm still a plumber. Even though all of you want to force your stories about your down under parts on me, I'm not interested. So give a call to old Peterson's Plumbing and Sewage. I got a special on snaking out your pipes this week. If so help me God, you mention anything but the job at hand, I'm gonna knock you out!
Oh, I'm Stan Pan Phillips, and I hope you're ready for all the local high school football action every Friday night on Football Fridays on Channel 8. Yeah, we'll come on right after the news, and boy, oh boy, we're gonna talk high school pigskin, the sacks, the punts, touchdown, yep, Football Fridays, right after the Channel 8 news, probably at 12:05 or something, field goal.
A little known fact, before Dingbats was a comedy club, it was a rock club, and it was opened in 68 with a performance from a band called, at that point in time, the New Yardbirds, who later became Led Zeppelin, on 108.9 The Honk.
Sounds like a good rock fact right there.
That does sound, oh my God, well, you know, we've just been having so much fun here, talking to Nick and Brian from
BriTANick.
BriTANick.
I said bite. That's not even part of it. That's not in there.
Well, we'll just change it right now. It's BriTANick.
Bite. BriTANick. Okay. And you can see them tonight. Sold out show, guys. Huge. Sold out show.
Sort of. Kind of. It sounds like you gave our tickets away to a person who won't show up. So.
Yeah. I mean, did he actually get the ticket? Like,
no, he hung up. There are still tickets hanging out in limbo.
Okay.
I can go back to the phones. To callers. Here we go. At least, like, don't give it all to one guy, because then he'll just show up by himself.
Well, I mean, I don't know. I don't know how this works. Allison in promotion gives me a big pack in the morning of the coupons that I'm going to use for the week.
Could you give the tickets to us, and then we'll sell them on the street?
Well, you have to win them.
Yeah. What?
Classic rock rules.
You got to call in and win them. Rules.
Yeah.
We have to call.
All right. What's the number?
555. 555-555-555-555-555 and then
I think that's too many digits.
Dial 5.
No, it's Val Verde.
No, it works.
I got it.
Okay. I'm glad someone's calling in.
All right, line 2. You're on 108.9 The Hawk.
Hey, it's me. It's Brian from BriTANick.
Oh, Brian from BriTANick. Wow, that's kind of crazy because we have BriTANick on right now.
Would you like to talk to Brian from BriTANick?
I mean, yeah, sure.
Brian.
Yes. Yeah, hi. Hello. Hey, what's up, Brian? Hi, Brian. How you doing? I'm pretty good. Hey, listen, nice. I heard you got tickets for your show. Can I have them? Hey, guys, I think you should give our tickets to this guy named Brian.
Yeah, let's give it to this guy, Brian.
Allison, do we have the
Nick,
tickets?
Nick, we're on the phone here. Could you not chime in? We're trying to handle something.
Participate in this?
Wait, well, we are on the phone. This is just how it works. I know you're new to classic rock. Let us do our giveaway here.
New to radio, new to comedy. Sounds like it all.
Like he's calling to talk about our show. I feel like I should be able to chime in.
No. Right. Okay, Jeff, you were a little too angry there.
Yeah, that is my name.
The angry man was a little too angry. Nick, Nick, go ahead.
Hey, hi, Brian.
Hey, Nick.
We're gonna give you the tickets. I hope.
Great. I hope I win them. Do I need to do anything?
I'm not sure. It seemed like they were down to give it to the other guys.
There's one question. If you were
could be a member of the Traveling Wilburys.
Oh, this is a good question. This is a good question. God.
Which Wilbury would you be?
Which Wilbury?
What would your Wilbury name be?
You got to give a Wilbury
name.
And
remember, your last name's Wilbury. So you're just you're coming up with a first name. But I need to hear it from the caller, not from...
And I'm Jeff the Angry Man Gog, but I'll still give you a little hint. Don't say Don Amici. It doesn't work.
Don Amici Wilbury's
not a good one.
Not a good one.
Mama Llama Ding Dong Wilbury, baby.
Yeah, no, that's a no one.
Why didn't you say Brian Wilbury or something like that?
See, that would have won.
That would have gotten you the tickets. Unfortunately,
I thought Mama Llama Ding Dong was Brian. Cool.
We didn't win this time. We're hanging up on you.
Thanks for calling, Brian.
Brian,
I'm calling. What a fucking idiot.
Seriously, I haven't had a caller that fucking stupid in ages.
I thought that was like right up your guy's alley with humor and everything. My God.
I guess I fucked up.
We had a call.
Clicking on 69 there. Hey, 108.9 The Hawk. You're here with Wisp Turlington. Hi, who do we have?
Nick, where are you calling from?
Yeah.
In the studio.
Are you guys not able to see us put our phone up to our ear and that we're the same person? Or what's happening here?
Sorry, Brian. We're talking to a caller here. We're trying to do a contest.
I don't know. I mean, I'd love to win
BriTANick tickets for Dingbats tonight.
Well, it's going to take a trivia question. Jeff, hit him.
Got a little question for you. Are you a fan of the Traveling Wilburys?
Please say yes.
All right, fantastic. Now, if you were a traveling Wilbury.
Brian Wilbury.
What? Sorry.
Allison says it doesn't qualify.
Didn't finish the question.
What
if you answer before, these are the rules.
What are you looking for in this question?
You have to let me finish the question before you answer the question. These are classic rock rules, and we say it all the time here on 108.9 The Hawk. If there is one thing that is important in classic rock, it is rules.
Rules.
Rules are the most important thing in classic rock and roll.
Rules are the most important thing in classic rock!
You know, I'm the angry man, but you're making Wisp angrier than I am right here.
Fuck it. Hit it. Hit the goddamn... delay. Fuck it. Give him another question. Give him another shot. This is for all of the bingo coins.
Nick, do not interrupt him.
I'm not going to.
Nick.
Yes.
You're in heaven.
Okay.
You gotta come up with your dream band because you're surrounded by all the dead musicians of the world.
Yep.
Okay.
I like where this is going.
Who is the manager of this dream band?
I gotta go with that, the manager of the Beatles. His name is Brian.
What's his last name? We need a last name for this one.
Can I ask?
You want to phone a friend?
Can I ask Brian?
You do have three lifelines.
My comedy partner, Brian, who I know knows the answer.
I guess we're going to find out what kind of partners these guys are. Let's see how close friends you guys are.
What's his name, Brian?
Epstein.
We got a winner.
We got a winner.
Hey, you just won 80 tickets to see BriTANick at their sold out show.
Remind us, who is this again we're talking to?
It's Nick. I'm in the studio with you.
You can see him holding his phone to his face right in front of you.
You're going to have a good night tonight, Brian. Hey, we're throwing in a gift certificate to Flappers. Just to know, you do have to spend $50 to activate it, and then it is $20. So it's going to be a great time.
But luckily, the Tower of Iced Tea costs
$50. $70 at Flappers, I will die.
You might want to check your credit card bill from last night because I think you probably spent that. It is not a cheap restaurant. It's not a cheap restaurant.
Oh, my God. I got to say, you guys are going to have such a great time tonight at Flappers seeing BriTANick. Nick, do you like comedy, Nick? He hung up.
I guess we're never going to get that answer.
I just put the phone down because we're all talking.
Apparently, we did not get the information from the caller for the tickets.
I can give it to you. We know it.
We have it. We have the information. Well,
tickets are up for grabs, people.
Tickets are up for grabs again.
It's going to be a good show. Hopefully, you'll get some people out there tonight.
I tell you what, whoever does win these tickets, you get to see this show with these great skit comedians. I'm going to feel one thing. And that's jealous again on 108.9, The Hawk. You guys are from Atlanta. These are your guys. These are your friends.
It's good to be in Hotlanta.
See, the Black Crows get out of a bus and they're like, it's good to be in Hotlanta again.
Not everyone from Atlanta
says that. I
gotta
be honest, I don't actually know that much about rock and roll.
Well, good thing you came here. And now we're in the interview.
Perfect line to end the episode.
Nick, Ryan.
Thank you.
BriTANick.
We know who you are.
Welcome
guys,
to
we
Runaway
were just fucking it. The whole time. Yeah. Just you fucking guys, around.
I'm really excited.
Why is Jason doing this weird voice? I don't get it.
Oh, who is this guy? It was me.
I thought for a second you were still in character, and it's like, now it's time for the interview. And I was like, what have we been doing this whole time?
I did. I think I was in a little bit of a wisp there.
It's hard to get out.
Nick Kocher, Brian McElhaney, and BriTANick here. I've known you guys, 6 years now?
I guess we met at the beginning of 2016, or yeah. I guess when we joined SNL, we sort of met.
Yeah, you guys are the best. You guys are the absolute best, and I'm so excited you're taking your show to Edinburgh. And for 25 shows, and there will be people there. We were just fucking with you there.
You might not be. We've heard from a lot of people who are like, there's 15 people in every audience, so right. You could have been totally on the money.
Yeah. Yeah. No,
but you'll have fun at least. Edinburgh is a fantastic place.
Yeah, we're excited.
It's like, it's a thing that you always want to do as a comedian, and just to like knock that off and mark that off your list and just have fun while doing it. And I mean, getting back together in like, well, not that you guys ever broke up, but like doing this show that you're doing now with like older sketches, some new stuff. How has that process been?
I've loved it. I mean, just, you know, like everyone, we haven't really performed much over the last few years. So it does feel like, you know, coming back to... There was this thing called the novel coronavirus. Did you not hear?
No, I didn't hear a thing.
Sorry, we shifted into character for 2 seconds.
Yeah, I
totally didn't understand how the world worked.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's been great to get back on stage, and people seem pretty ravenous for, you know, just live theater, and it's just great. I mean, you know, Nick and I have been doing sketch since 2008.
Yeah.
And I feel like there's not that many sketch groups from that era still doing sketch. So it's like the fact that we're like picking up the pieces and doing it again, we're like, are we crazy, or are we just like just pushing forward, just trying to make BriTANick happen over and over again is sort of just kind of
I think it's exciting when there's a new BriTANick sketch that comes out. I get excited when something new will pop. Like, I'll be like, hey, there it is.
Yeah. We have a new video sketch we just shot, which I think all of our fans are like, what? Guys, every 3 years you like tease us by like
the
coming back
model.
And then go away.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. And the truth is we're not coming back and going away. This is the pace. It takes us 3 years to make something, and that's we're on schedule for what we've planned to do.
Look, you guys make stuff that when you're a sketch comedian who shoots videos, you guys will put something out, and then you're like, ugh, I don't want to. They did it better. Like, they put in the work that I'm not too lazy to do. God damn it.
You know, I'll tell you, there's a little story I like from, so Penn and Teller, right? Teller has this thing about magicians. He's like, the thing about magicians, what makes them so special is they make a quarter disappear, then pull it out from behind your ear. And in your head, you're like, okay, either real magic exists, or that man spent hours, if not years, alone in his bedroom practicing making a coin disappear just to fool me, another adult, for a second. Clearly, that didn't happen, so magic exists. But what happened is that man did spend all that time. That's kind of how we feel about our sketches. It's like we spend a year making a 2-minute sketch online, and people are like, this is so great. Like, look at all this, like, the craftsmanship. And it's like, we spent way more time than anyone ever should making a sketch.
But it is also, I will say, a fun counter to everyone who poops out everything.
Yes,
now.
We are definitely a counter to.
Honestly, like, where you're just like, or take a breath, everyone. Like, maybe think about your shit for, like, 5 seconds bit longer.
You don't have to rush out your fucking first thought.
Right.
Yes.
And that's so many of the videos out right now, which is, that's so much of the comedy that's out. Like, someone will do, like, a front-facing video that is just, like, them shitting out their first thought and, like, oh, it's up there. And then those explode.
Yeah.
And those are great. Yeah. Some of those are, like, fantastic.
Some of those are truly
good. And that's
good.
Really infuriating when it's good.
Yes.
God. Yes. They're prolific and good.
But when they're bad, ooh, it feels good.
Oh, boy.
It's the best feeling in the fucking world. but you guys are so August 3rd through the 28th. Is that
that's
when?
Right. That's right. Yeah.
At the
then we're gonna do a week in London after that. So.
Fuck. Where are you going? So you're at the Assembly George Square at the Box.
That's right. Yeah. Yeah.
7:45 p.m. And then we'll go immediately after Edinburgh. We're going to London to do the Soho Theater. We'll do 4 shows there.
Fuck yeah, right. We got a lot of London Hawk fans. So
good.
Listening there, you guys go out to Soho. What, Soho House? Is that what you said?
Don't go to Soho House. It'll
go out to the Soho House. Get in line now.
They'll be just get in line. But that's
go
huge.
To Soho House
that
to
is
say,
huge.
I'm here to see the sketch comedy, please, and see what happens.
Is Hee Haw the stage show here?
I think
Did you guys watch Hee Haw at all growing up? Was it
no?
You're too young for it.
Okay. I didn't watch it as like a child, but like I watched it. I've seen clips of Laugh-In, and I can't believe that was a show. That is one of the wildest shows in the world.
Yeah,
people.
It was also
it.
The first $1 million question on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire that the guy won for.
Oh, for Laugh-In.
Oh, right. Yeah. That was the which president was on Laugh-In?
Oh, yeah.
Richard Nixon.
And Lauren was a writer for Laugh-In.
Was he really?
Yeah.
I can't remember the name of it. I want to say. I might be merging. Remember when I think Steve Martin did like he tried to do like almost a version of Laugh-In where it's all 15-second comedy and it's very quick. And I almost want to say it was presented by Kelsey Grammer. I might be merging a whole bunch.
Yeah, it seems like there's a stew of comedy in your brain.
I think you were having a stroke.
Yeah, and then I had a stroke and thought, well, my life. I just stared into my comedy career and went, no,
and then fell off a stage. Good Lord. But yeah, guys, this is huge. This is so huge. I'm so excited for you. Do you guys have to busk? Is that part of the process? Are you going to be part of that where you're come see the show?
We're flyering, flyering. Is like, I think it's kind of cool because it's like, I think you get a little comfortable, you know, when you have a career and you work in LA and New York. But to go to a place where no one knows us and we have to like get people in the seats, it's humbling in hopefully a good way. So, we'll see.
Thank you guys so much.
Thank you guys so much.
Thanks for having us, guys.
You guys are the first guests to play yourselves, too, which is very exciting.
It was just a no-brainer for us to be Brian and Nick.
It worked well.
It worked well.
It's kind of nice that like to have your like crazy characters and then two people who are like entering a cartoon world.
Yes.
Going, what the fuck is...
Safe travels, have some break some fucking legs. It's going to be great.
Thank you, guys.